honest, long, sincere, dedicated, understanding. She was everything a man could ever want a woman to be. She was everything to me, and she was my woman. I can remember the first time we met in New York City, Central Park. I was wearing a pair of white sneakers and a pair of white shorts, and I had a white t-shirt on with the inscription that read in the front of it, Earth, Wind, and Fire. You could not tell me that I was not good to go. Oh, we got married. Wait, 2 days later we got married and everything was cool for about 4 years. And that's when the other voices came into the picture. You know what I'm talking about when I say the other voices? You know, Mary said that Roy was running around with Harry and Beverly, and he got back to the home front. And me and my old lady started going through a repetitious cycle of splitting up and coming back together and splitting up and coming back together until it just got ridiculous. You know what she said? She said, Roy, I said, yo. She said, Roy, if you don't stop playing that music, running all over the country like you're crazy or something, I'm gonna leave you. I could not believe my ears, so I went outside and took a walk around the block. I came back in the house, and I walked up to her, I said, come again. She said, if you don't stop playing that music, running all over the country like you're crazy or something, I'm gonna leave you. You know what I told her? Bye. Now, I don't wanna sound cold, I don't wanna sound hard, but you know, a man can only take so much. And that was too much for me. Let me go back. Let me just forget about that negative thing. Let's go back to the positive. Remember when we were in the park? We had a blanket. We were laying there in the park. I'm gonna tell you the first words I whispered in her ear. I pulled her close to me and I said these words to her. Check this out. Let me kiss you on your poo, poo la la. Ooh, baby. You got to let me kiss you, kiss you. Let me squeeze you on your deal, da da. Ooh, baby. You got to let me kiss you, kiss you. And I squeeze you real tight, I said, Jack and Jim, we're headed up the hill. Fetch a pail of water. Jack fell down and broke his crown. Jill said, just don't break your poo-poo la la. Oh yeah. Anyway, 4 years passed. There I am sitting in my R-A-N-Y-C-B-A-P-T, Roy Ayers, New York City, bachelor apartment, doing my thing, minding my own business. As a matter of fact, I was looking at the television, and the telephone rang. At that time, I had incorporated into my voice pattern what I call my Barry White approach. And I picked up the phone and I said, hello. There was no answer. I said it once again. Hello. And this voice came on the phone. It sounded just like this.